At dawn, on an early spring morning, more than 3,000 years ago, two armies faced one another at Mu Ya. It was to be a critical battle, one that would end the Shang Dynasty and allow the emergence of the Zhou Dynasty. On one side was a rebel army fighting the tyranny of the Shang Dynasty. The other side was a provisional army of slaves and prisoners commanded by King Xin of the Shang Dynasty. In this decisive battle, he was without his main army, which was on an expedition along the state's remote borders. The ethics of that age made it immoral for the rebels to plot such a surprise attack, especially launching a rebellion against the sacred ruler of the country. It was also a strategic risk to face the Shang army, which greatly outnumbered the rebels. King Wu of Zhou, his strategists and generals were confident, emboldened by their 300 chariots, the most advanced military attack vehicles of that age. The chariot was drawn by two or four horses. It was controlled by a charioteer in the middle. There was an archer to his left and a guard on his right. The soldier on the right was armed with a dagger, axe, and lance. In addition, all three carried a sword and an axe for self-defense. They wore helmets and a suit of armor, and carried a shield. A well-designed chariot was maneuverable and suitable for either attack or defense.
当时的战争主要是在黄河中下游的冲积平原，这个地区呢，它的这个自然地理就非常平坦，适合这个战车作战。那么从当时的社会条件来说呢，当时采取的是井田制，整个的这个道路规划的网络和这个。 道路的质量都非常高的情况下，更适合战车发展。The
chariots were fast and could easily move to where they were needed on the battlefield. It was costly to raise horses and maintain the chariots, but their speed made them a superior weapon. Bai Meng Chen, editor of Weapon Magazine, and Lu Qi, editor of Top Gear Magazine, wanted to know just how fast a chariot from 3,000 years ago could go. To ensure an accurate result, they used modern equipment that's used for car testing.
It
required several days to train horses to draw the chariot. It wasn't an easy task. In ancient times, the term state of a thousand chariots was used to describe a military power. It's easy to imagine how important it was for an army to invest in horses and chariots. In both the Shang and Zhou dynasties, the chief commander of a state's military affairs was given the title Sama, literally meaning administrator of horses. This demonstrates the tactical and strategic importance of horses.
The
meter shows a surprising result. After 12 seconds of acceleration, the chariot reaches its highest speed of 21.6 kilometers per hour. This speed is the equivalent to that of a marathon runner. Is this the true speed of an ancient chariot?
那么这个速度在战场上实际上基本上是不会出现的，因为我们说中国的战车呢要带几十名的这种步行图兵，那么21公里的这个步行的城镇型士兵来讲有点太快了，那么如果这个速度呢，它的阵型就解体了。The
ride confirms the suspicions of the testers. The chariot shook violently at high speed.
一直在紧紧抓着那个车的槽帮，然后甚至这个两腿我觉得都挺用力的，才把这段坚持过来。
In fact, it required intensive training to control a chariot in combat.
这个呢是贵族垄断军事的一个手段，所以大家都要学。那么一般来说呢，它从相当于我们现在的，比如说六艺之二，就是书和数，写书法和这个计算。
A chariot was not as fast as you might imagine, but it was almost unstoppable in battle. The top speed of a tank used in World War I was no more than 10 kilometers an hour, but its power was decisive. At the Battle of Muya, the Zhou launched the first attack. They advanced slowly and carefully maintained formation. The foot soldiers and chariots remained in line with each other. At intervals, the advance was stopped to regroup the formation. As the army closed in on its enemy, the charioteers began to move faster, and the archers started shooting arrows as the guards cut down any soldier within reach of a dagger axe or lance. The chariots easily overwhelmed the foot soldiers. The Shang dynasty troops knew the beat of the horses' hooves and the sound of the chariots meant certain death. All they could do was stand in formation as ordered to resist the enemy. A simulation of the attack at the Battle of Muya shows what happens when chariots race at full speed into a line of foot soldiers. In this display, it's necessary to maintain the speed and momentum of the chariots. To understand how much injury chariot wheels and horses' hooves can do to the human body, artificial hooves made of bamboo are used. The speed is set to 15 kilometers per hour.
这个几个这个假人是全撞飞了，这是四个，撞倒了四个，
刚才这次模拟实验撞倒了四个模拟的这个人形，要是真实的情况下，这四个人的损伤都会非常重要。 前面迎面受到撞击，多发性肋骨骨折、骨盆骨折，下边的下肢骨折，这都会发生。This
is a bronze axle cap. When attached to a battle chariot, it's designed to act like a sharp dagger. To get a greater understanding of how deadly the chariots would have been in battle, a track is built to test the speed and impact force. Wires with weights attached are used to pull the test vehicle and adjust the speed. The axle cap is attached on one side. It will most likely hit the legs of a soldier. The leg of a pig is used in place of a test dummy.
这下是威力真的很明显，好家伙，这个口也够大的哈。
这是八公分，要是在前侧隔，动静脉肯定要断，
全部都断，打出血
断了，
对，打出血。如果侧面也到这个大转子，
也到骨头了，那证明我们这个车位对这个人的这个至少是人的大腿最粗的这个位置，能够达到一个很有效的杀伤。
它的主要用途呢，实际上是当两个战车都有一个长位的时候呢，驾驶员就不得不让双方的车辆保持一个合理的距离，那么就避免了这个战车在战场上发生这个堵车的现象，就这个互相冲撞，自己的这个人撞在一起，实际上战车才因此才能保持机动性。In
many ways, the battle chariot was similar to a modern tank. During World War I, as the British tanks moved toward the enemy trenches on the Western Front, the German soldiers were terrified. It's easy to imagine how the foot soldiers of the Xiong dynasty reacted when 300 chariots moved toward them. The battle became a massacre. When the battle chariots broke the front line of the Xiong dynasty, the foot soldiers were cut down. Following the chariots were warriors sworn to serve King Wu of Zhou, each was carrying an expensive bronze dagger and a shield. The end of the Shang Dynasty was unavoidable. When two armies fought at close quarters, the warriors on the chariots began to use dagger axes and lances, while archers continued to shoot arrows at the enemy. These dagger axes and lances were usually fixed on handles more than 3 meters in length. In the Bronze Age, these were among the most deadly weapons in battle. A dagger axe typically has 3 blades, an upper blade, a sharp tip, and a lower blade, each capable of causing major damage. A recreation is set up to see how much damage a dagger axe will cause when it strikes a target made of pork covered by leather armor.
然后就是这儿，
皮甲已经烂了，两层皮甲没有什么实际效果。您看这侧面这个，是不是等于是把脊柱都打，整个打断了？是，
骨质已经断裂了。
那如果要是从后面打人的话，是不是人的脊柱也能击断？
可以，
对，这个武装甲的或者是有装甲这个着击，我们可以看到都是完全的深入进去了。那么就证明了它对这个就是人体的这个着击这个效果是相当好。
上刃在我们的这个实际的作用中，只在皮甲上造成了几道这个痕迹。那你的这个上面这个挑刺的功能不明显，那么最终就跟毛结合在一起，变成了我们的一个很有名的兵器戟。那么也就是说，用这个完全用毛头来产生这个穿刺的效果。那么也就是说，上面这个部分实际上被大家完全忽略掉了。Compared
to a lance, a dagger axe has a longer reach and is more useful for multiple strikes. Facing warriors wielding a dagger axe from a chariot, the foot soldiers had little chance of survival.
Gu呢，它是和战车相伴相生的。那么在这个战车的兴盛期，Gu的数量就多；当战车衰落了，Gu的数量就少。 那么从这个车上的武士呢，他用戈来这个横扫对方的步兵，就不用像用矛那样单个去瞄准，它效率很高。那么从戈的制造角度说呢，由于戈它需要的铜比较少，那么这个和相对和斧啊和其他的兵器来说，它的成本低，可以装备更多的军队，所以就是中国大量使用戈的原因就在这里。
In addition to the 300 chariots. King Wu of Zhou had an elite force of 3,000 warriors he personally trained. Well-armed and extraordinary in stamina, they would not flinch in battle. The chariots and foot soldiers coordinated with one another on the battlefield. When the chariots moved in a row against the enemy, the foot soldiers around each chariot would try to maintain a formation, offering mutual protection to one another. The Battle of Muya lasted only half a day. At noon, the Xiong army was completely defeated. The earth was soaked with blood. Di Xin, the king of the Xiong dynasty, stood atop his palace and set himself ablaze. The 600-year-old Xiong dynasty was over. For much of history, the battle chariot was the dominant weapon of war. However, as iron weapons and crossbows became more common, the power of the infantry also increased, and the development of the cavalry made the battlefield increasingly more mobile. As old war ethics died out, battles were no longer fought at an agreed-upon location. Since battlefields were no longer restricted to being on flat land, chariots began to fade from use. It was an innovative weapon. A top-secret new weapon for the dynasty of China's central plains to resist cavalry attacks. The crossbow became the new weapon of choice on the battlefield.